being so quiet? make some noise. No, I didn't mean applause. I meant kind of...
We're dreaming.
I meant like the fortune god, everybody, it's a deafening roar.
You've got us spellbound. We're spellbound.
No.
Thank you.
No applause is necessary. Just intelligent nods. You people, you're not talking enough. I don't feel at home. Everybody.
Thank you. Thank you.
lesson of
I just want to say thank you.
Anybody,
worldwide,
anybody?
Nobody happier than me right now.
Hey, Tom, what can I play? If nobody else has a request,
I
can I play for you?
What can you play for me? Well, I don't know.
Okay.
I just wanted to say.
I thought about a rain medley. Rain and rain and
open. Yeah, but look at it. It's nice.
Rainbow on my shoulder, around my shoulder.
I knew you. I don't know that one.
Just,
I remember Frankie Lane said, I don't know that one.
Hey, time out a minute. I want to say something about the artist.
All right.
You guys, I
didn't have a chance. Word. Excuse me.
I didn't have a chance to predict what he was going to play because you've already heard it. And the music obviously speaks for itself, and I know what I can't really critique it except to say that I really appreciate it. I want to be thanking Dave for coming here today. Dave fitted this in between a trip to New Jersey club played last night and a trip back to Cape Cod where he lives. I just have a few things I want to say about Dave. I first met Dave, I think I met him first at a New Year's Eve gig that you were playing with Bob Wilker.
Yeah?
At the Captain Linnell House on the Cape. And that was a great evening, and he even let me play it to him.
he plays good, this guy.
Since then, I've tried as hard as I can to hear him when he comes to New York, but he doesn't come to New York all that often. He's been a fixture at the Copley Plaza Hotel for many, many years until he just stopped a regular appearance there, I guess, about a year ago. And he's now a worldwide performer, mainly solo piano, where everybody, or anybody, I guess, wants to hear great music. Matter of fact, Jack Lesberg tells me a guy wants to have him come to Stuttgart for his birthday party. December.
Yeah, I've never had a gig like that. That is not, you're making it sound as though that's kind of, I've never done anything like that before.
Dave plays in a worldwide location known as Whiskey World. Bar Room Piano. Dave isn't a jazz artist as much as he's just a piano player, man. He plays all the old songs. Plays any song you ever
I didn't know his request, though.
Even the simplest songs
I didn't know his request.
Heard.
What did I tell you?
The simplest songs you've ever heard, the composer would kill to have thought of the chord progressions that this man plays on his little simple tune, like, what was it, Alexander's Ragtime Band. I heard him do 10 minutes on that in the Carnegie Recital Hall to a standing ovation. Billy was there. Right? I mean, that it's like five chords and
it's a great song.
When I hear Dave play, Dave puts harmonic pressure on you. You can't stop listening. Man has a computer up here that nobody else has. God creates these things. Wilbert once told me, you all know Bob Wilbert. I think practically every year has heard him play in this room. And Wilbert once told me, I have to tell you this one, Dave. He said, McKenna can play any tune in any key, and he's never heard
play mistakes all around.
I just cover them right
up.
In.
All right. I cover them up.
He's a New Englander, a Red Sox fan. I would say to the piano, McKenna is to the piano what.
Ted Williams.
Shall we pick Ted Williams? Can we pick Ted Williams? That's the baseball hit. The splendid splitter of the piano, Dave McKenna.
Thank you. Spring can really hang up the most bebop ballad.
Spring can really hang.